Dear brothers and sisters in Christ, distinguished guests, and participants of this August gathering. I shall read the message of His All Holiness, Ecumenical Patriarch Bartholomew, to the Friends of Mount Athos Conference in honor of His Excellency Metropolitan Callistos, beloved colleagues, students, and friends of Metropolitan Callistos, esteemed conference speakers and participants, dear friends of Mount Athos. It is our sincere pleasure and privilege to respond to the gracious invitation of your Honorary Secretary, Dr. Graham Speak, that we address a brief paternal message to the participants of the residential conference organized in honor of His Excellency Metropolitan Callistos. We are delighted to do this through our exarch in Great Britain, His Eminence Archbishop Gregorios of Thyatira. There is no greater honor for a church than to pay tribute to one of the most eminent hierarchs and prominent scholars of the ecumenical throne, who for many years has served as spiritual father, academic teacher, metropolitan bishop, monk, theologian, and author, translator. We understand that speakers will address the manifold virtues of Metropolitan Callistos' life and the diverse aspects of his work, the one face and many facets of the productivity and legacy of this respected leader of our church. Our beloved brother Metropolitan taught numerous students at the University of Oxford for 35 years and ministered as a clergyman for over 45 years, I think, 50. Eh?
Not quite, but yes, 50.
50, I'm right. In next month, I think 50.
48.
He recently celebrated his 80th birthday and has variously supported and presided over the Friends of Mount Athos, which is currently celebrating its 25th year of growth. One could endlessly describe the contributions of Metropolitan Callistos to the Orthodox Church in general and the Ecumenical Patriarchate in particular. However, we shall confine ourselves to highlighting the fact that one could never calculate the number of people who have embraced or admired the history and teaching of the Orthodox Church through his classic works, The Orthodox Church and the Orthodox Way. Moreover, one could never imagine the number of people whose lives have been informed and transformed by the translation of the writings on prayer and spirituality known to us through the Philokalia. We would like to assure you that while our numerous commitments regrettably prevent us from attending in person as we certainly would have liked to, we shall nevertheless be with you in thought and prayer as you consider and celebrate the acclaimed career and vocation of the recipient of your tribute and homage. Therefore, hyperpanton και apano, for this and for all things, we give thanks to the Lord for the gift shared with us by His Excellency, Metropolitan Callistos, to whom we pray that God may grant many years rightly to divide the word of His truth. Prayerfully yours, Bartholomew, Archbishop of Constantinople, New Rome, and Ecumenical Patriarchate. You will allow me to say a few words on this special occasion for honor of my colleague and friend and co-bishop in Metropolitan Callistos. It is a great privilege to be present at this conference celebrating the 80th birthday of my brother Bishop Mitropolitan Callistos of Dioclea, and to have had the honor to read the august message of that His Holiness, the Ecumenical Patriarch Bartholomew I, has addressed to the gathering. I think that I am right in saying that the first time that I saw Mitropolitan Callistos, or as it was known, Timothy Ware, as he was there, was with a group of people who had come to visit to my church where I was serving as our sense in Camden Town from 1959 to 69. I got to know him better and appreciate his abilities and talents sometime later when I was driving the car in which he and my predecessor of blessed memory, Athenagoras Kokkinakis, were traveling, and I vividly remember how they were discussing the question of his ordination and how he agreed to become a clergyman of the Orthodox Church and of this eparchy of the Ecumenical Throne. Indeed, it was I who, as a priest, gave him the canonical letter of witness, Symmartyria, as we say in Greek, prior to his ordination as a deacon in the Greek Orthodox Cathedral of the Divine Wisdom, Hagia Sophia, in London, which took place almost exactly 50 years ago, on the 3rd of March, 1965. When he was ordained to the priesthood the following year, after having been tortured as a monk of the monastery of St. John, the theologian in Patmos, I remember him assuring me that the community in Oxford was now guaranteed a priest for the next 50 years. I remember it vividly, and it was a bit surprised, but I shut my mouth. For me, this showed not only his humility and prophetic vision, but also his humor. In that university city, he taught both academically and spiritually, putting the Greek Orthodox community on firm foundations and being one of those responsible for the building of the Church of the Annunciation of the Mother of God, today shared with our Mother Church parish within the Archdiocese of Orthodox parishes of Russian tradition in Western Europe. Although his name is inextricably linked to Oxford, it has become well known throughout the whole world. It is already engraven in letters of gold on the pages of theological writings and studies, and the internet reveals the titles of his books and the numerous papers, articles, and translations that bear his name. He has glorified the name of the patriarchate that has honored him with the episcopate, and he's also a compliment to the nation that gave him birth. As an assistant bishop of the Archdiocese of Thyatira in Great Britain, we have always had excellent relations, and his cooperation has always been beyond reproach. He has passed the royal years, dear friend, dear, and he has already lived for 10 years those that the psalmist claimed are, even at the best of times, years of toil and trouble, because meekness came upon us and we shall become disciplined. And yet, even if a little less physically strong than of previous years, he has proved the psalmist wrong as he continues to teach and instruct, rightly proclaiming the word of God truth, maintaining evangelical humility and being an example and inspiration to thousands of Orthodox Christians and those who are not, who have delved the depths of the Orthodox way by way of his teaching and academic ability. In brief, it is right and proper that we should be celebrating this 80th anniversary of Metropolitan Callisto's birth and at the same time the 50th anniversary of his entry into the ranks of the clergy of the Orthodox Christian Church. May Almighty God grant you length of days, good health, and sharpness of mind for many years to come to continue to glorify the name of the Holy Trinity, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, now and forever and to the ages of ages.